This has been a longstanding issue in healthcare.
Disparities in healthcare when it comes to minority and low-income communities are not new, even when it comes to COVID-19, according to Dr. Claudia Fegan, Chief Medical Officer for Cook County Health.
Totally different subject, but if we look at breast cancer statistics, we see that white women who are high school dropouts have better survival statistics than Black women who have a college degree.
Is it because there's no access, or is it the communities are resistant to go and get the help?
Access is a very important issue and should not be diminished, but it's also having, being able to deliver care to people and not do it in a one box fits all.
Another problem is underlying health conditions such as asthma, diabetes, and heart disease, which are prevalent in communities of color. They increase a person's vulnerability to coronavirus. Dr. Susan Rogers says living conditions also play a role.
People are living in a more dense environment, which makes the transmission of the COVID virus more. And then there's not an opportunity for testing healthcare early on in any disease, including COVID.
The latest statistics from the Illinois Department of Public Health show of the confirmed cases of COVID-19 in Illinois, 33% are white, 31% Black, 10% identify as other, 3% are Asian, 23% didn't answer. When it's broken down by ethnicity, 54% are non-Hispanic, 8% are Hispanic, and 38% didn't answer. Dr. Fegan says those numbers don't tell the whole story.
I don't think we have a good handle on what the community prevalence is, because we have not really uniformly begun testing folks who are under 65 and the majority of people who present with these symptoms.
No insurance or poor coverage also plays a role.
It's difficult to access care because of not being insured, not having healthcare facilities in some neighborhoods. So minorities have been disenfranchised from healthcare for a variety of reasons over the years.
Dr. Rogers and Dr. Fegan say there are no easy answers right now. They say the best things that any of us can do are to practice social distancing and to wash our hands.